A five-day search came to an end Thursday when law enforcement arrested Brian Anthony Roden, 23, who, they believe, is responsible for the deaths of three people whose bodies were found on a Kennesaw golf course Saturday. Roden was charged with three counts of murder, three counts of aggravated assault and two counts of kidnapping, Cobb Police Chief Tim Cox told reporters at a Thursday evening news conference. Police believe Roden to be the lone shooter. Roden's Cobb County arrest warrant, unveiled Friday, includes new details, accusing Roden of binding with tape the hands, legs and mouths of victims Paul Pearson, 76, of Kansas, and Henry Valdez, 46, of California. Pearson and Valdez were found dead in the bed of a pickup truck that was left at the 10th hole of the Pine Tree Country Club golf course. The truck was registered to Pearson. Golf Pro and Pine Tree's director of golf Gene Siller, 46, went to investigate the truck on the course Saturday and was fatally shot by Roden, police say. It remains unclear what chain of events led to the truck being driven onto the course, and what relationship Valdez and Pearson may have to the suspect. Roden's first appearance in Cobb County Magistrate Court was scheduled for 8 p.m. Friday. Visit mdjonline.com for coverage. Details have now emerged that Roden was in custody and released before police charged him with the killings. Just hours after the shooting, Roden was arrested on separate charges in Chamblee. According to DeKalb County jail records, Roden was arrested Saturday for driving under the influence and several related violations. He was released Tuesday night after bonding out. Roden was pulled over by Chamblee police around 11:30 p.m. Saturday because his taillights were not working, according to a DeKalb County arrest warrant. The officer then determined the tag on the vehicle was not registered to the vehicle and the vehicle had no valid insurance. Police also found two IDs in a book bag with different names and information but with the same picture. The officer also smelled a strong odor of alcohol coming from Roden. Police conducted a field sobriety test, which Roden failed, according to the warrant, although Roden was breathalyzed and blew less than the legal limit. When asked at the Thursday press conference whether he was aware Roden had been arrested for a DUI Saturday, Chief Cox said he had been told that he had a previous arrest, but declined to say whether the department knew at the time that their suspect was in custody. Friday evening, Chamblee police said that Roden was still unknown to law enforcement as the shooter when he was charged with DUI. Chamblee police also provided new details by saying the initial DUI arrest had incidentally led to Roden's murder arrest being uneventful. Police had confiscated an undisclosed, large sum of money from Roden when charging him with DUI. Roden wanted it back and ended up walking into a trap.